rappers and music producers, Curtis King of CurtisKingTV.com, and today we're going to discuss how to kill a troll. Oh, you coming in hot and heavy on a Monday, huh, Curtis? You damn right. Let's talk about it. Rappers and music producers, how many of you got trolls? It feel like the word haters kind of got evolved into trolls, and it seems like even trolls have evolved into gremlins that sit under a bridge and they eat peanut butter and macaroni and cheese sandwiches, and they're like, oh, whose day can I ruin today because I feel so bad being underneath this bridge, ain't no friends here, whose day can I go fuck up? Monetize that, by the way. Trolls are around, and you know what I always said? Troll, I think, is the root word of control. Talk about it, Curtis. Preach to me. I said troll is the latter part of control. And what I mean by that is that these people are here to control your attention, to control the narrative, to control not even just your attention yourself, but the attention of your audience. That's why they jump inside the damn chats and they be like, bro, what's going on with your hairline? And I'll be like, yeah, it's crooked, but my pocket's straight. And they be like, shut up, because they mad. They don't like the wittiness, but some of them do like the wittiness. At the end of the day, what they really want is attention. So here's my solution when it comes to trolls, because I used to believe in engaging with trolls. I used to hit them back, like many of you. You see some stuff, and it's almost like trolls are like, they have like the sensibility of kids. You ever get some kids that come around you, and I don't know how they know whatever you're the most insecure about?
I spy with my little eye something that is red.
What's that?
But they come up on you and they like, damn, what's that bump underneath your neck? Was that a hickey? Who you been kissing? Who kissing on you? She got rabies. And then they do that in front of your family and it's like, little boy, you're not my son, but if you was, I whoop your ass. And you can't do nothing about it because you don't want your auntie, you don't want nobody to be mad at you for trying to whoop your little, whatever. You get what I'm saying. These kids have a sensibility that these trolls have. These trolls will look at your video, right? And they won't even talk about the topic. We could be talking about bananas in pajamas. And they come around and they like, bro, are you racist against apples? And you know, what the hell are you talking about? How did you conclude that from my statement?
Well, I'm just saying, bro.
Anybody who say, I'm just saying, bro,
not trying to be a hater, but
they always are exactly what they say they're not trying to be.
Not trying to be
you trying to be a hater. That's exactly what you're trying to be. And so when I had to get into the minds of a troll, here's what I had to understand. Trolls are no different from any other human beings. Human beings have 6 primary needs. 2 of them are for the soul and for your growth, okay? Human beings have a need for 1, certainty. 2, uncertainty. 3, significance. 4, loving connection. And the 2 that you need for growth, the 2 that you need to be happy and fulfilled, growth and contribution. Contribution is something that's bigger than you, are growing at something that makes you just genuinely feel happy. Growing in a relationship, growing at your art form, right? Or even contributing to a community like I do at CurtisKingTV.com. Cue the commercial.
It'd be a shame if you had to miss all this great content, huh? You finna miss out? Because you don't got $20? This is information straight from Curtis King. And you get to talk to him and a bunch of folks in the community? Man, come join us at CurtisKingTV.com, where it's uncensored, uncut, and we're taking back ownership. It's only getting better.
Damn.
But that's the point. Most of these trolls are satisfying some of their other primal needs, and you only need 3 needs for it to become an addiction. You know how people get addicted to trolls? Let's get right in their damn heads, since they don't like that. They never show their picture. They always got a profile picture of something exploding and it's never their face. Or they got a picture of a Soulja Boy. Talking about some Drake. They always got something else that ain't them. You know why? Because if you don't even like yourself, why in the hell would you like me? Thought about that? If they don't even like their damn self, of course they gonna come be disruptive. Of course they're not gonna like you. But let's talk about their needs. They have a need for certainty. They know if they say the opposite of everybody else that's showing love, they will get a reaction. Also, they feel significant. Damn, somebody who's bigger than me, that got more followers than me, they get all swole like that. They got more followers than me, actually pay attention to me? Didn't nobody even talk to me the whole damn day, and now this person that's verified talked to me? They feel significant. Third, they feel love and connection in a weird, funky ass way, because if everybody is throwing hate towards their way, sometimes some people feel like hate is better than indifference. Sometimes indifference is people's biggest fear. So if you are showing hate, you're showing all of this emotion towards them, in their heads they're like, well, I'm done for the day, but the problem is that they're never fulfilled. So, that being said, now that we've got into their damn brain and we know how they work, how do you kill a troll? You starve them. Curtis, how do you starve them? You starve them of attention. There are tools on the internet like blocking, and talk about muting, Some of you fools is probably on Twitter right now watching these videos. I don't know why you watch the shit you don't like. Monetize that. I don't know why you watch the stuff you don't like. But you have been arguing with me for the last 6 months. You've been on mute. I don't even know you arguing with me. And then I'll be looking down like some of the responses to my tweets and I'll be like, damn, why this person muted? Maybe I was just being emotional and being sensitive that day. And then I unmute them and they like, typing in all caps. And I'm like, it don't matter how loud you yell, fam, you on mute. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? You need some milk? What's wrong with you? And then I mute you back. This time I block you because I'm like, at this point, it's just unhealthy for you to be around. So how do you kill a troll? You starve them. Eventually, those people that continue, you know, when they realize you're never going to hit them back, well, no matter how low they hit you, they get bored and they go to somebody else that's going to give them attention because they have necessities as human beings. How do you kill a troll? You starve them of attention. Nothing else. Move on with your life. I made a New Year's resolution this year not to respond and not to argue with people that don't have profile pics of themselves, because like I said earlier, if you don't even like yourself enough to put up a picture, especially in this narcissistic ass generation where everybody got pictures of their damn self, because we supposed to love yourself. I shouldn't even say narcissistic. You supposed to love your damn self. In this generation, it's the selfie generation. It's not the Polaroid generation. It's a selfie generation. You ain't even got a picture of yourself, even making a goofy face. You need somebody else's face to represent you, somebody else's imagery. You don't even like yourself. You got things you got to work on. And me responding back to you, let me tell you, as my mentor, one of my friends, and I look at him as a mentor, my homie Chris said, Curtis, I understand sometimes you want to be witty with them, sometimes you want to make an example of them, but at the end of the day, you know that responding back to trolls is not scalable. Anybody who knows me knows that I'm a businessman. I'm definitely a creative, I'm a man of the people, but I'm also a businessman, and I believe in scaling up from where I'm at. And if I have something that's not scalable, that's actually being something that's a liability to my business, I must bid you farewell. Once again, you've been watching another video from Curtis King TV of CurtisKingTV.com. For those of you that are not subscribed, boys, subscribe to the channel. Stop playing with me. You stay to the end. That means you like something. Go ahead and subscribe. Hit the bell. Bring. Hit the bell. Be a part of the notification gang. I don't know what this is at this point, but you just roll with it. You understand the topic at hand. If you want to get rid of a troll, just start from of attention. Get the hell, tell them, show. You got stuff you got to do. Because in this life, you will not be full of life until you decide that you sign up to CurtisKingTV.com and become a member because you tripping. Come over here to this other side. Get some of this content that goes more in depth and it's just exactly what you are looking for. And it's not just information. You come in here, that's just the tip of the iceberg. Be around people that are supportive and the first healthy mental health space for rappers and music producers on the internet. It exists at CurtisKingTV.com. And like I always say, in this life, you would not be full of life until you decide to live life to its fullest. Once again, it's Curtis King, the leading voice of the online rapper and music producer community. Don't at me. Peace.
Wow. What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brandman Sean, and I got to talk about my guy, Curtis King, just a little bit. This dude right here brings so much value to the independent artist and producer community. It's ridiculous. I got a chance to discover him like so many other people just through YouTube, but then follow and see that if you follow him, man, you'll get real results. There's a lot of people giving bad information out there, and there's a lot of people giving good information, solid, but they don't care. And Curtis cares. So you can tell he cares, and he was doing it way before it was cool to just give information just so you can attract artists, right? Some people are doing it from different places, and I appreciate that about Curtis. I really look forward to see what you do. I see some of the things you're doing. I see it's going great places. I support Curtis King. This is Brand Man. I'm out.
Look up, Nazi. Say cheese.